We then went the whole hog, cut the strings, and dunked the chicken legs completely in the acid. And that was really fascinating. The chicken leg in HCl and in sulfuric acid just went a bit more yucky, if you like. The solution got darker color, and the color is probably due to the pigment, the myoglobin, reacting with H plus from the acids. So it just becomes more light absorbing. But with HF, the chicken leg, first of all, visibly starts looking almost like shredded, pulled chicken meat, and it goes dead white. Before, it looked a sort of yellowy color, and it looked like corpses, one imagines corpses to look. This, the meat went absolutely white.
Skins come off.
And then at the end, because Neil had to neutralize these, you can't put highly acid chicken legs away in the waste. He dropped them into solution of carbonate, I think potassium carbonate, where the residual acid reacts with carbonate to produce carbon dioxide. As the chicken legs were dunked into the carbonate solution, they started bubbling. Now, the first thing that was interesting is the leg that had been in sulfuric acid, which had been rather more buoyant than the other legs. It didn't sink as well in the sulfuric acid. But once it got in the water, it sank like a stone. The HCl and the HF both stayed near the top. The HF really bubbled much more, suggesting that the acid could penetrate much better in the meat. I mean, after all, a chicken's leg is not just meat. It is highly structured muscle so that the chicken can run around and try and escape the farmer. But all of that structure has been destroyed in the case of the HF. With the sulfuric acid and the HCl, there has been some destruction, but the meat is still recognizable as meat. But essentially with HF, it has gone completely white. And there is more bubbling because this white mass is now like a sponge and can just absorb much more acid. So it's a bit like the chicken leg has turned into a paintbrush. I think it's a really interesting experiment. In a way, it's far more interesting than we expected. I mean, we went home really disappointed. You know, we'd spent all this money on the chicken legs, nothing happened. But in the end, I think we learned a lot more about the chemistry than we'd expected. First of all, that HF seems to destroy the pigments in meat very quickly, and also, what is quite interesting and you don't normally see is that the structure of meat, when you remove the pigments, is absolutely white, almost like cotton wool or something like that. So I think in the end, it's been quite a good lesson. I think it's important to stress that this is a demonstration, not an experiment. We didn't have a hypothesis beforehand, except that it might dissolve. But it did have at least the beginning of the scientific method in that we had two control legs so that we could notice differences. If we'd just done the leg in HF by itself, we probably would have missed some of the most interesting features. So the moral is, think what you're doing before you do an experiment. you might learn a lot more.